Just with the motherboard, we can know if the device is working properly. These checks are very useful to solve a broken screen in a mobile device. If the device has no sign of life, why to buy a screen? We must first solve the motherboard and then to change the screen. In the second case, we find a low-end mobile device. It's an extremely economical device built with a reduced amount of circuits and function. On the graph, we can observe the same pattern, a less pronounced rise followed by stabilization. As it is an economical device, the graph is not as saturated as in the first case. I have left for the end a medium-range device to make a comparison. When we connect it to the laboratory power supply, a pronounced rise is observed, followed by a couple of peaks and subsequent stabilization once the operating system has been loaded correctly. This is one of the most important stages when we are repairing mobile devices. With time, we are learning new knowledges about it. Here I leave you a few graphs for the power buttons. There are plastic power buttons that must be pressed to activate it, as well as flex-type power buttons that also contain the volume controls plus and minus. However, the way in which they are measured is the same. We just have to measure the voltage when we are pressing the power button.